Hello friends, once again I am there, and today I am going to tell you about the detailed program structure and what is the meaning of each thing as you are mentioning in the Java program, like public, static, void, main, etc., class, what is the meaning of public, and so many other things I am going to tell you. I am switching to my board, and then you will be seeing. Now I am coming to my screen, my board. So friends, last time I told you a very simple Java program, in that I was writing import Java dot lang dot star. Okay, now after that I was writing public class test. Okay, and after that I was writing public static void main. Okay, and inside that I was writing string args into brackets, and then, and now open brace for public static void main I am writing here, and what you have to do, I was writing system dot out dot println println, and then I was writing engineer. Okay, I was closing public static void main, and now I am closing the class. So this is the closing of class, this is the closing of method. So now inside that we will be studying detail of this import java dot lang dot star letter, but in short I can tell you Java is the main package. Inside that is sub package is lang, and I am going to import all the classes from this lang package. So you can understand it just like that. There is a big folder Java here. Inside that there is a one small folder, or you can say the subfolder is lang, lang, and inside that this lang many dot class files are there. Now what is the meaning of dot star? Dot star or asterisk means each and every class will be imported inside my program. Now public static void main. Now there is one important thing about the public static void main, that if you are using public, now listen it very carefully, that if you are using this public, then the if this is public, then this program name always I have to save this inside a file. I have to save this complete inside a file, and I am considering the file name will be test.java. The file name will be test.java. Now what is the meaning of that? If it is public, then necessarily the name of class and name of Java file, that will be same. Okay, if it is public, the name of class file and name of Java, name of class file and name of source file, that will be necessarily same. We'll do it practically. Okay, okay, if it is public, then name of class file and name of class file and name of source file necessarily same. If I am not using this public, in that case the name of source file and name of class file, they may be same. So if I am using this public, then both must be necessarily same, just remember it. If I am not using it public, in that case the name of class file and name of source file may be different. Now next thing, public static void main. What is the meaning of public? Means this will be accessible everywhere. what is the meaning of void? It will not be returning anything. Okay, that is why I am not using return there. return, I am not using this one because it is not going to return anything. If I am writing here int, then this will become necessary. So I am not writing here int, I am using void. That is why no any need to use any return statement. Okay. Now what is main? Main will be telling to compiler. Main will be telling to compiler that from which place the execution or the compilation will be started. So first of all, the compiler will be searching where is the main, and that interpreter will be seeing where is the main, and from this place the running will be started, particularly from main running will be started. If this main is not available, your program can be compiled only, it cannot be run. If main is not there, what will be happening? If main is not there, then what will be happening? Can you compile and run both? Then compile, you cannot compile. Just you can see here, you can compile or run. Compile or run. Then you can if main is not there, then you can compile, you cannot run the program. If main is there, then you can compile and run both. You can compile and run both if main is there. If main is not there, then you can compile, you cannot run the program. You will not be able to run this program. Okay. So I think I told you so many things related to that. Now you can see it here that system dot this public is clear, main is clear, void is clear. Now what is the meaning of static? Basically, whenever we are calling any method, there is one class XYZ. Inside that there is one method void pqr. Okay. Now you want to call this method pqr into another class or somewhere else. In that case, first you have to create object of this class XYZ. XYZ O1 equal to new XYZ. Like that you have to do. After that you have to write O1 dot pqr. Okay, this is the way. But if I am declaring it static, if I declared it static, then no any need of creating the object. This is not required. It is not required. What you have to do directly with class name, you can write here XYZ dot PQR. Means if you are making any method static, then no any need of creating the objects. Directly by the class name, you can call that method, as I am doing here. Particularly if any method is known static, then you have to create the object first, you have to write this line, and then with the help of dot operator you have to call that method. Okay, pqr. But if you are declaring anything static, then directly with dot operator and with the help of class name, you can call this method and you can utilize this. This is the meaning of static. So if I am going back to my previous page, then you can see I told you what is public, I told you what is test, I told you what is static, public, void, main, and what is the interpretation of each. Okay. In last, I told you main is not there. If main is not there, if any program is not having main, that can be compiled, but that cannot be run. If main is there, then that can be compiled and run both. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of this string args? Basically, when we are creating commands, this string args is used in the creation of commands. Now, you can come here and you can check what is the string args. String args, string, string args. It is available inside the main. Okay. you can see it here. In main, we are writing string args. What is the meaning of this string args? Particularly, when we are writing any command, like I am writing copy, copy t1 dot txt, okay, copy to any folder, folder name. Means, what is the meaning of that? This is the program name. This is arg 0, this is arg 1, like that we are going. So, when we are making commands with the help of Java program, with the help of Java program, then we have to use this one, otherwise it is not required. So, today I am not going to test it. First, I have to test in which way the I am going to the previous page, you can see it here. I am going to explain you how to use this static and at what place the class file will be prepared, at what class, at the place where the class file will be prepared, and maybe I will be telling this thing to you. If I am not able to cover it, then I will be covering something in the next lecture. Okay, so just I am going to test each and everything. I covered all these things. Now come back to the screen. Just see it here. I think netbin is available there. Just a minute. Just see, netbean is available there. Now I will be writing two programs. I will be correcting both. Now I will be putting one semicolon there, okay, and I will be putting one semicolon there, okay, and I will be writing be an engineer in 301 program. 301 program. And now you can see here in 30 program, in 30 program, program, 30 program, okay. Now I am going to run both independently. After that I will be telling the use of static to you. So at this place you are seeing be an engineer in 30 program, and here you will be seeing that I am going to run it be an engineer in 301 program. Now I will be calling this 301 Java program inside this one. What is the way of that? Because I told you, if you are using this static, then no one need to create the object of this class directly with the class name. And what is the class name inside that? You will be seeing, this is my class name Java application. So I am copying it, Control C, and I am going to put that in 30. Now here I will be Control V, and just after putting the dot you will be seeing the main will be seen automatically here. So now if you are running this one, earlier when I was running it, you will be you were seeing only the single be an engineer in 30 program, you were seeing this one, okay. Now this time when I will be running it, this program will be run automatically by the running of that, and you will be seeing the output of both programs. So this time be an engineer in 30 program and be an engineer in 301 program, okay. So this is the meaning of static. If I am not using this static, just remove it, then naturally this will be displaying some error, okay. Now no, this is okay, static, static. I have to remove the static of this one. I have to remove the static of this one. Just remove it. Now when I will be coming back to this, then you will be seeing some error, because Java application 30, this cannot be called, because now this main is not static. That is why I am seeing the error there, that Java application 301, and what is the name of error? You can see it here, known static method main cannot be referenced from the static context, means directly with this class name this main method cannot be called. So how to correct it? Just go inside here and write here static static. Is it okay? So now it is okay. Now one more thing there, as I told you about the public, just come back to the screen. Sorry, control Z. Okay, just come back to the same screen. Come back to here. Come back here. And now I told you that about some this public. Okay, when this public is to be put? When if I am not putting it, then what will be happening? Particularly, when I am putting it public, then necessarily the class file name and program file name must be same. Okay, so if I am removing this public, then you will be seeing the different result and you will be getting error. Now I am going back to the my NetBean screen. Okay, just come it here. By chance I typed something wrongly here. Now this time I am going to change the name of this. So I am saying this is 303. Okay, you will be seeing some error. Now what is the error there? It is suggesting me, NetBean is suggesting me, class Java application 30 is public, should be declared in file name Java application 303. Means now the class file name and the program file name both are different. Program file name is Java application 30 and class file name is Java application 303. That is why you are seeing the error. Now there are two solutions for that. See it very carefully. Either you have to make the source file name and class file name must be same if it is public. So what is the solution? Just make both the same. So error will be resolved. Now if it is 303 and there is no any effect on my program or my programming or on my project, that it is not required that it should be public, so I can remove it. So in that case also, now you are seeing there is no any error and class file name and program file class file name and program file name both are different. This is class file name and this is program file name, both are completely different. This is 30 and this is 303. In that case also you are not getting any error. If I am typing back public public, then immediately you will be seeing one error through NetBean. So NetBean will be helping you in this way also. So today I told you two things: what is the meaning of this public, static, void, main, what is public, what is static, what is void, what is main, and practically I represented both the things to you, that what is this public, static, void, main, what is the exact meaning of static, if I am putting the static then what will be the effect on my program, if I am not putting the static then what will be the effect on my program, and second thing I told you what is the meaning of this public class. Okay, now second thing I am going to tell you, if I am not using this main, I am not using this main, then my program can be compiled only, it cannot be run. So just I am going to copy it back. Friend, this is very important thing for the programming, that you have to test each and everything. Just we are memorizing all these things and we are not testing. So this time first I have to correct the error of this. So I am correcting it back. Both are 30, so my problem is resolved. Now this is my new program, and what I am going to do inside that, just I am going to type going to print this BN engineer. Okay, and delete it. Now BN engineer, and you are seeing here public class 3011, so it is a completely different class. This time I am going to use a different function name or method name inside that, and that is I can say ABC. Okay, so just public, just a second. So I was telling you that you have to type here any function name as you want, like I am typing here ABC, okay, but I have to write that in method form. So public void, I have to write here void, means my method is not returning anything. Now this time you are seeing public static void main is not there. So can I compile it? Yes, I can compile it, but I have to test it that it can be compiled or not. I can compile it, but it cannot be run. When I will be running it, you will be seeing the error, class Java application 30, Java application 30 does not have main method. So as I told you, just come back to the screen and you will be seeing, as I told you in very beginning, that public static void main, if this main is not available there, just your program can be compiled, it cannot be run. Just once more I am coming back and I am seeing this program can be compiled only, this cannot be run, okay. Just I am going to run that, then at the time of running means Java interpreter will be starting the interpretation from the public static void main. It will be searching where is main, and exactly from the main the running of the program will be started. If you are not having main, then your program can be compiled only, it cannot be run. So friends, today I told you three important thing, and we did the practical on all. Like what is a public class? If I am putting public, I am not putting public, then what will be happening with my program? And second thing, I told you what is the meaning of public static void main. Exactly, I did the experiment on static. And third thing, I told you about the public static void main. If I am not putting public static void main in my Java file, then what will be happening? I will be able to only compile that. I cannot be run. I cannot run this program. Okay, thank you. Just subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so that whenever a new video will be coming, then you can see it. Thank you, friends. Okay.